Complete the example. Navy pilots. Women's heights are normally distributed with a mean of 63.7 inches and standard deviation 2.9 inches. The U.S. Navy requires that fighter pilots have heights between 62 inches and 78 inches. If the Navy changes the height requirement so that all women are eligible except the shortest 3% and the tallest 3%, what are the new height requirements for women? It is a normal distribution. I'm going to draw the normal curve. I'm going to label the information that I know. I have a mean of 63.7 inches. That immediately tells me that it is a non-standard normal. Z is always zero at the mean. And I am looking for the new height. So I'm asked to find X, which means I must have some areas somewhere. And I do. The areas are here. I need to know where the shortest 3% of women mark would be, that X value. That's going to separate the bottom 3% from the rest of the population. And then I need the mark for the upper 3%. Now this would coincide with P97, and this would coincide with P3. It's the X's I'm interested in. I can find the Z using the table. Use table A2 to find Z, and then plug in that Z number into the formula to find X. So go ahead and use your table, dig that out, and find the negative Z score for an area of 0.03. I'm going to look in the body of the table for 0.0300, and the closest I get is 0.0301. My Z score for that area, the bottom 3%, is negative 1.88. That's the number that goes here. And then I plug it into the formula, 63.7 plus negative 1.88 times the standard deviation of 2.9. And I find that minimum height. Oh, that's not what I wanted. I wanted the little calculator. 1.88 times 2.9. equals, change the sign, add it to 63.7. I end up with a height of 58 if I round to the nearest whole number, and that's inches. And then I'm going to use the same kind of procedure to find the upper limit, or in this case, the height that would separate the top 3% from the rest of the population. And here I'm going to find that Z is 1.88. Plugging it into the formula, I get 63.7 plus 1.88 times 2.9. And finding that number, 63.7 plus 1.88 times 2.9, I get a height of 69.152. So I get X is equal to 69 inches. The height separating the lowest 3% from the others is 58 inches. Oops. And the height separating the highest 3% from the others is 69 inches. So that would be the height requirements for women if everyone was eligible except for the shortest 3% and the tallest 3%. Significantly low or significantly high. Here's an example. Significantly lower, significantly high female pulse rates. Use the criteria given in preceding sections to identify pulse rates of women that are significantly lower, significantly high. Remember, we took the mean and added and subtracted two times the standard deviation to find that the value that separated what was considered usual from unusual. Based on data set 1, body temperature, in the textbook appendix, assume women have normally distributed pulse rates with a mean of 74.0 beats per minute and a standard deviation of 12.5 beats per minute. Here is a pictorial representation, which is our step 1. We begin with a graph, as shown in the figure. We have entered the mean of 74, and we've identified the place where the x values separate the lowest 5% and the highest 5% from the rest of the pulse rates. Using table A2, find the area in the body of the table closest to 0.0500, just like in our preceding example, and then identify the z-score, find the area of the body in the table closest to 0.9500, which is going to give you this value, and then the associated z-score. And you'll notice that the z-scores have been identified and are highlighted below the figure. Solve for the 2x values by using the z-score formula. So you plug in, just like we did with the Navy pilots' height requirements for women, and we end up with a beats per minute of 53.4 for the number of beats per minute that separates the significantly low beats from the not significantly low beats, and then similarly for the significantly high number of beats. Referring to the figure below, notice that the values are now entered beats per minute for significantly low and significantly high. Here's the interpretation of what that's may be used for. So here are the pulse rates of women that are significant. Significantly low is 53.4 beats per minute or lower, and significantly high would be 94.6 beats per minute or higher. One use of this information could be that physicians could take the results and decide maybe they need to investigate some health issues that may cause a woman's pulse rate to be significantly high or significantly low. And let's try one more example in context. So complete the example low birth weight. The University of Maryland Medical Center considers low birth weights to be those that are less than 5.5 pounds or 2,495 grams. Birth weights are normally distributed with a mean of 3,152 grams and a standard deviation of 693.4 grams. And this is based on data set 4 births in the textbook appendix. Find the weights considered to be significantly low using the criterion of a birth weight having a probability of 0.05 or less. So I'm looking for the birth weights that are significantly low. So I want to find the weights. That means I'm going to find x. It is a normal distribution. I'm going to draw the normal curve, and I'm going to label the information that I know. It is not a standard normal. It has a mean of 3,152 grams. Z is always zero at the mean. I want to find significantly low birth weights, and we're going to consider a probability of 0.05 or less to be significantly low. This is 0.05, and this is the x that I'm looking for. Again, if I can find the Z, I use table A2 to do that. And I'm going to find X by plugging in the values of mu, Z, and sigma into this formula. Table A2. Now, this is a negative Z, and I want an area of 0.05. And so if I look at 0.0500, that's going to be the negative 1.645 number. Negative 1.645, plugging that into this, I end up with x is equal to a mean of 3152.0 grams plus the negative 1.645 times the standard deviation is 693.4. And using my calculator, I have 1.645 times 693.4. I'm going to change the sign on that because a negative times positive is a negative. And then I'm going to add 3152. So I get 2011.357 grams. That's this X number. So the solution is that birth weights are significantly low if they are 2011.4 grams or less.